thank the organizer in chairman LMCCI for organizing and giving us this opportunity to talk to you, to interact with you. And my special thanks goes to Habib Bhai and all his staff who have been working throughout day and night, you know, making our life very comfortable. Basically, I am from the education industry. We have a university there in Assam, which is one of the largest private university. And coming back to the things here, what I was thinking that to build up a university, we require four pillars. We generally call there are four pillars of the university. And one is a world-class infrastructure, which is very much required. The other one is your brilliant faculty. The third one is your international collaborations. And the fourth one is the research. So that we can attain employable education. That is the thing which we are trying to do in our university. And we focus into our university as a career university. So that is where we are developing a teaching methodology where a lot of skill inputs are there along with the formal curriculum. Now, I was just wondering that Laos can be, you know, a great, great center if we could develop a knowledge city in Laos. And that is what I was discussing with His Excellency, that sir, we would be, you know, interested to bring investment to develop a knowledge city in Laos. If you see the strategic location, as Mr. Ahuja has rightly said, that it is surrounded by five countries. So now education is becoming expensive in Thailand, it is becoming expensive in Singapore, it is becoming expensive in Vietnam, and Myanmar and Cambodia doesn't have very good education infrastructure. So Laos can take the lead of creating a world-class infrastructure in knowledge city of maybe 1,000 acres, where world-class universities can come and form their campuses, and they can attract students from all over this region. And of course, India would be the biggest market from where the students can come and study here and go back and go back to their country. So that is where I think there is a lot of possibility. And together with that, educational tourism can be developed. And together with that, yes, His Excellency was telling about the medical sector. Again, once we develop this kind of knowledge city, medical university or medical college can be part of this university, this knowledge city. And there again, you can develop a lot of medical tourism into this. So this is one probable area where I'm finding will interest us a lot. And this is where I think we can focus. That is one point. Now, to create this kind of things, we sir require two or three things which are basic requirement, because educational industry is very capital intensive, and the sustainability depends, it's a long-term project, and the sustainability depends on two major factors in attracting the faculties and getting the investment at a lower rate of interest. So this is two things, and of course the land. So these are the three things which are mainly required for the educational industry. And if you could look into these three factors, that if you can facilitate interest, borrowing at a low interest rate, and creating a land bank of say 1,000 acres in areas which are well connected, so that international faculties can come, which would be linked to the airport. So these are the few things which if the government can look into and find out a suitable place, then I think this is a very good destination for this kind of investment. Now going back to our own Northeast, I think our earlier speaker has covered, Pankaj has covered about the investment in Northeast, but most of this financial investment, the financial subsidies which are given to the industries in Northeast, I think the most important thing which Laos is giving us is people to people contact. because already the Laos delegation has visited Guwahati and northeastern region, and this is the most important, crucial part of any investment. So when people to people contact are comfortable, then you know the investment can flow in. It may take some time, but I'm sure that investment will flow in, because if you see the demographic conditions of Assam, the region, and Laos, it is almost the same. Yesterday we were just having our sightsee. We were going to Mr. Habib's plantation, and we were seeing the countryside also, and we felt as if we were in Assam only, that we are not in a different country. And even the human resources which are available here, very similar to Laos, our human resources are also very similar. We finally is organizing a trade and investment summit somewhere in February, Indrani, if I'm correct. So I'll request the Chamber of Commerce from Laos and any other investors who are interested, they can come explore even Northeast. I'll also take this opportunity to highlight some of the achievements which our team members are there into. Mr. B.L. Agarwal, he is basically into prefabrication. So any investor who wants to be connected to him on infrastructure and prefabrication, he is the person. Mr. Chinmoy Sharma, he is from entertainment industry. He is a man of diversified field. He is a man from entertainment industry. He is a man from organic fertilizer. He is a man who is into solar renewable energy. So anybody if wants to get connected to him, yeah, he is there. Mr. Pradyut Bhuya, he is into infrastructure, and also he has got a manufacturing unit of Horlicks, which is one of the biggest units in Asia. Ranjana Bhajanka, she is a landscape designer, and anybody who is interested to get for infrastructure projects, she can get connected. And of course, Pankaj is there for cement manufacturing. Their prime interest is cement manufacturing. And Mr. Sharma, Mr. Barua is there, who is into your food processing. With this, I conclude. Thank you all.